Well, this program, I mean, quite literally how it came about. Yes, it's a part of the Baroque festival. But again, I was handed a piece, a copy of this Stabat Mater by Scarlatti, and I did not know this piece. I didn't even know it existed. So I thought, well, yes, okay, I'll take a look at it. And I thought, I played it through, I thought it's a fabulous piece. So I said, yes, this, we must definitely do this. I'm very happy. Usually I'm, you know, I find my own music, but occasionally someone will put a piece in my hand and, you know, so it produces results. I like that. I really do. Given the choice, of course, I would normally prefer to do it in a church, provided the acoustics are good. Not all churches have great acoustics. And we have a concert hall here that does have great acoustics. It doesn't have the reverberance of a church, but it actually, it's a very good acoustic for singing. So I don't really hesitate to do church music here. Now, if we want to talk about whether it's appropriate, I would also argue, actually, yes, I think it is. At that time, concerts were just beginning to exist. There were no such things as concerts until the early 17th century. And even then, it was a new thing and it gradually developed. But it was very quickly obvious that people performed in concerts whatever they wanted. And I think we can be fairly certain, frankly, that Renaissance composers, for example, would have wanted their music to be performed in concerts if concerts had existed, and been very happy, thank you. Why not? You know. So I think we get a little bit too carried away with this authenticity. I'm not terribly interested in it. It's more a question of the environment and the acoustic above all. And as I say, there are some churches with dreadful acoustics, and then there are other churches where you can only do things which have a long reverberation, so you can't do anything too fast or anything. And that can be a problem too. So, no, this is fine.